liver fat, what are the six foods that you will avoid, that you will never consume, that harm, that worsen the process of hepatic ketosis, of fatty liver? And what are the five foods that you will consume, that you will add to your diet, that have scientific evidence, that can improve the process of reversing fat in the liver or stabilization for you to maintain not worsening the hepatic steatosis condition? Very objective video. I'm going straight to the part of feeding treatment. I'm not going to do that whole introduction like in the other videos because you guys asked for it a lot in a specific way, this theme. What to eat and what to avoid. Only I ask you to leave your like, already leave the likes. This is crucial for the channel. Let's aim for 10K likes. This way, YouTube knows the video is relevant and distributes it to more people. There are millions of people who have fatty liver, who have hepatic steatosis, and do not know, simply do not have the guidance of what they can and cannot eat, what things they have to avoid and what they should consume, which have scientific evidence that improves. So if you haven't activated notifications either, do it now so that whenever I post, YouTube will notify you. I am posting videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Well, there are six foods that you will avoid. What are the six? Number six, alcohol. Even if it is not the cause of your fatty liver, you have to avoid alcohol because it worsens the process of, if you have hepatic cough, it gets worse. It even causes damage to the liver, even in small amounts. Dr. Joao, I drink weekly. Even so, you will cut out alcohol, so remove it. You must put in the effort to develop a liking for it, as it significantly worsens the problems, which is a serious issue. So the initial food, in quotation marks, that you will not consume is alcohol, beverages containing alcohol. Number five, processed fats, saturated fats, then yellow cheeses, very fatty meats, foods that contain a high level of saturated fats, such as ice cream. You must remove these foods from your diet to maintain a healthy lifestyle and ensure optimal well-being. If you are unable to completely eliminate it because it is challenging for you to remove all of these foods, make sure to choose the ones with the least amount of saturated fats. So get used to looking at the little labels, the tags. There's a label with the nutritional values. Prefer foods that have less saturated fats or that do not have saturated fats. Through your participation, you also contribute to this process. Number four, a built-in feature. So, cup, salami, sausage, parma ham, they are foods that are good, that many individuals enjoy eating, but they contain numerous preservatives and can also exacerbate the development of hepatic steatosis, a condition characterized by the accumulation of fat in the liver. Ham, turkey breast, you also need to avoid. Therefore, ensure that you steer clear of these processed foods. It's our number four. Number three, for you to delete. Foods that have a lot of sodium, such as salt, processed foods, a classic example, instant noodles have a very high amount of sodium. Condiments, sauces, some types of ketchup also have a lot of sodium, mayonnaise, mustard. Avoid this type of food. Additionally, if it contains a high amount of sodium, you should exclude it from your diet, as sodium and processed foods can exacerbate the fat processing in the liver. Number two, fructose syrup. Cornstarch also greatly worsens the fat processing in the liver and should be excluded from the diet to prevent further complications. See if the food you consume does not have this type of syrup, fructose syrup. Because one of the worst foods, if not the worst food for liver fat, is fructose syrup. The number one you should remove, write down everything. If you didn't get a paper or a pen, or put it in the notepad on your phone, do it, because it will help you a lot. And the primary thing you should eliminate is simple sugar. What would that be? Simple carbohydrates, such as flour, for instance. The sugar itself, refined sugar, pasta, always make an effort to add fibers to slow down the absorption of these foods, or opt for foods with complex carbohydrates to ensure a slower release of energy and better overall health. I will provide you with an example, such as pasta. You should consume whole wheat pasta, rice. You should consume brown rice. You should avoid juices, which have a high glycemic index, such as grape juice, orange juice. These are the foods that the body will take and convert into sugar in your bloodstream. Even if you do not consume sugar as such, you should avoid it. Good, Dr. Joao, I'm not going to eat anything. I'm going to tell you the five foods you're going to include in your diet now. If you have not liked it yet, you can see that this video is very valuable. So help me as well. Well, number five, what are the five foods you will consume? First, add turmeric. Turmeric or turmeric. Some regions commonly refer to turmeric as turmeric spice or golden spice. If you consume turmeric, season your food or make any recipe with turmeric, it can aid you in the process of reversing and stabilizing fat in the liver, providing potential benefits for liver health. It is extremely important. There is scientific evidence that this can be beneficial. And in case you include, if it is a spicy food, such as black pepper, for instance, it will enhance the potency of turmeric. So your body will absorb a greater amount of turmeric when consumed with pepper. An interesting tip to keep in mind. Food item number four that you should include in your diet, fruits. Which types of fruits? No fructose? It has fructose. But what worsens the process of fat in the liver is the excess of fructose. So what are you planning to do? What are the types of fruits? Acai, it is a fruit that also has scientific evidence, always pasteurized. Another fruit, arica, guava, avocado, all of which contain beneficial fats for health. So this aids in this process. It is our fourth type of food. The third food you will add is coffee, which will contribute to the overall outcome. That is correct. Coffee is highly beneficial. Why? Coffee contains polyphenols, antioxidants, tocopherol, which is a form of vitamin E that can also aid in this process. Caffeine, obviously, you're already aware of its stimulating effects, as well as flavonoids. And how? What do you have to pay close attention to? Coffee conservation. Improper storage leads to nutrient loss, leaving only caffeine and compromising nutritional value. What do you need to pay attention to? First, always purchase the coffee that you will consume in the upcoming week. If you can purchase weekly, it's better. You preserve more nutrients. If you can buy in bulk, it's even better. I had an objection, which I thought was too expensive to buy a grinder. Ah, it's very expensive. It is a lot of work, but no. I purchase my coffee and beans and end up grinding it, and you obtain much more nutrients. For those who have liver fat then, the grinder currently costs around $1.40, $1.50, and it lasts several years. I have mine for 3 years and it still works. I'm just not going to mention names here because it's not an advertisement, it's a commercial video here. However, try to check if you can't obtain a grinder and purchase coffee beans instead of ground coffee. Why do you take advantage of these benefits? Another thing, you have to protect the coffee from the light. If you keep a jar, it has to be a dark jar. Protect from light and also from moisture. So don't store the coffee in the refrigerator, for example. And also protect it from oxygen because it ends up oxidizing the coffee, removing these nutrients that are beneficial to your health. Exercise caution when it comes to coffee as it holds great importance. The second food item in your diet should be fish, specifically deep sea fish like salmon and tuna, due to their high omega-3 content. These fatty acids are beneficial for your liver health, aiding in the reversal and stabilization of hepatic steatosis, a condition you need to address and manage effectively. Ah, but Dr. Joao, what if I consume omega-3? The available evidence is limited, so there is no clear indication for everyone to regularly use omega-3 supplements. By adding deep sea fish to your diet, you can reap the benefits that this valuable inclusion brings to the table. I have studies on this in the Mediterranean diet, and the number one that you will add is fibers. Therefore, oats, chia, and flaxseed have a very significant benefit. Oatmeal also improves your lipid profile. Ah, so this is also scientifically proven. Include in your diet, choose a fiber you like most, for example, from these. Nearly everyone on a daily basis. I truly enjoy oats and flaxseed. And what about you? Consume any? Have fat and liver? What is the degree? If have hepatic steatosis or know someone who does, put in comments and also mention region you are from, your city, and your state. I always like to know. Now I'm going to give you a suggestion to watch. It's a video where I talked about the seven enemies of the thyroid that can harm your thyroid health. And also about the six false enemies that many people think harm, but actually do not harm. Do you want to know what they are? This is the video here. Don't miss it. A hug.